Hi everybody, it's Tatiana and today I am coming to you with another tag video. This is going to be the this or that tag. I've seen this on a couple of other people's videos and I like the questions and I wanted to answer the questions. So here we go. We're going to see if this actually ends up being a quick tag. I know I always say that the tags are going to be quick tags and they are rather long tags. So we'll see how quick this goes. Question number one, audiobook or in hand? I use both. I use in hand, book in hand when I am reading at home, but I do like audiobooks when I travel. It helps me, it helps the time pass quickly because typically when I travel, I'm on the road for 3 or more hours. So, and I'm on the road by myself, so it helps the time pass quickly. So when I'm home, I like in hand books. When I'm driving, on road trips, I like audiobooks, and also when I'm doing crafts, I like to listen to audiobooks, but most of the time that gets trumped by television. So, number two, soft cover or hardback? I prefer soft cover. I like getting hardback books from the library, but soft covers are more cost effective and they fit better in my budget than typical hardbacks do, unless the hardbacks are on sale. Most of the hardcover books that I have, I purchased on sale, either online or in a bookstore. I prefer a soft cover. Fiction or nonfiction? Fiction, all the way. I plan to tackle some nonfiction this year, but my preference is always fiction. Fantasy world or real life issues? Both. I like the fantasy world because it's the imagination that authors have. Or some authors have are great and it really takes you from where you are. And I also like real life issues because a lot of times the way that real life issues are tackled in stories helps you to understand mindsets and ideas that are different from your own. So both. Harry Potter or Twilight? Really, Harry Potter. Kindle, iPad, or other? I have a Kindle. I love my Kindle. I have a second generation Kindle. The reason why I don't prefer or don't want an iPad necessarily or a Nook is because I was not looking for another media device. I was just looking for an electronic reader and the Kindle appealed to me. At the time, the Nook wasn't even an option, but the Kindle appealed to me and I have had an ongoing relationship with Amazon since I was in college, and so I am just partial to purchasing things through Amazon. It's happened for me. I've only had a hassle once or twice, and each time it's been resolved effectively. So yeah, I chose to get a Kindle. I don't want a Kindle Fire. I don't need a Kindle Fire. How many media devices do you need? I have a phone, a computer, and a laptop. I'm good. I just need an e-reader. Borrow or buy? I don't borrow from a lot of friends because, as I said before, my friends don't read the same books that I read. So when I do borrow, I borrow from the library. And it all depends on whether or where my finances sit with how I've been managing them as to whether or not the preference for borrow versus buying would change. For now, I can say that I prefer both. I like doing both. I like borrowing from the library because you can get old books from the library, and I like buying because I can own them for myself. But there are some books that I want to read that I don't desire to buy. So yeah, either of the two. Bookstore or online? Online. I like bookstores, but my love for bookstores has gone down since Borders and Walden Books closed, and then the one Books a Million that we had near me closed, so that leaves me with Barnes & Noble, and I just don't have the, and have not been able to forge the relationship with the staff at any other bookstore as I was able to forge at Walden Books. So, but when Walden Books closed, I primarily went to shopping online. I miss my Walden Books, and I miss the people at Walden Books because they were fucking awesome. Standalone or trilogy? I don't know. I've read a lot of trilogies and series in the past year or, in like the past 2 or 3 years, and I think I've gotten away from the standalone. I said in my reading goals for 2014 that I wanted to read more standalone, because I am just out of the loop, and reading the standalone seems like so much information because I've been spoiled by the dragging out of a story that takes place in a series or a trilogy. So right now I will have to say trilogy, but I'm hoping that would change. Monster read or short and sweet? Absolutely a monster read. I have said before, the short story situation doesn't always appeal to me. It doesn't always work for me. I've read a couple that have been okay, but for the most part, they just seem so rushed. And it seems like there's so much more information that I would want to know that I can't get because it's a short story. So definitely a monster read. Starry-eyed romance or full of action? I like romance with some action in it, or action with some romance in it. Action with some romance in it. Because, yeah, who doesn't like a little bit of romance? And I love action. Love, 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 love. So if I had to choose between the two, I would say action. But if I could combine the two, action with a little bit of romance, it's the way to go. Curl up in your Snuggie or bathe in the sun? Curl up in my Snuggie. I attempt to read when I go outside or when I go to the beach or to the park, and I end up people watching because people do funny shit and people do crazy stuff. And to see that happening in real life is always more comical to me than whatever I happen to be reading at the time. So if I'm ever going to get any reading done in a relaxed situation, I would have to curl up with my Snuggie. Although I don't have a Snuggie, I just have a blanket and a robe, and that works. Hot chocolate or latte? Hot chocolate. All the way. Hot chocolate with whipped cream and marshmallows. Read the review or decide for yourself. I like to decide for myself based on the information that is on the book. I will read a review or I will watch a review on BookTube if I can be assured that there are no spoilers in reviews. I have an issue doing this, so I know that it's something that's very difficult to do. It's very difficult to do a book review without spoiling something in the book. But there are some reviewers on BookTube who do a very good job of not spoiling the book. Those I will watch. But other than that, I prefer to decide for myself. I watch a lot of reviews on BookTube. There are quite a few who do a good job of not spoiling a story. But it just makes me nervous that I'm going to hear something that's going to be like, you weren't supposed to know that until the end of the book. So sometimes I take a risk. Sometimes if they are getting what I feel is a little too in-depth, I will skip ahead in the video. But other than that, decide for myself. Or we decide for ourselves anyway, even after we read or listen to the reviews. We still decide for ourselves whether or not we're going to read a book based on whatever we read, be it on the back of the book, be it in the review, or be listening what we heard in the review. So either way, I decide for myself. Anybody's blurb, I guess, will do. So that is the end of the tag. And if you are seeing this and you haven't done it or you haven't seen it, I will put a link to a couple of the videos that I have seen do this down below. I know I saw Estelle do it, and I think I saw Bookadoodle do it. So I will put the links to their videos below, and I hope you all have a good weekend whenever you see this video. Peace out.